it's my honor and privilege tonight at the Clayton Center to be here with one fabulous artist and a little bit of everything, and we're going to talk about that. This is Maureen Wartski. Maureen, you live in Raleigh.
I do.
But where were you born?
I was born in Japan. I went to college here in the States. We lived in Bangkok, Thailand. We've lived everywhere in the world, probably.
Well, you went to Redlands.
I did.
That's out in the middle of the desert of California.
It wasn't a desert, a lot of orange groves.
Oh, okay. But anyway, I'm familiar with that part of the country, and you have gotten around. In addition to the art, which we're going to talk about, in addition to the art, you are a writer also, and you've taught writing and English in high school. Tell us about that experience. How long did you do that?
I taught English for some time, not for very long, because Proposition 13 and a half came and swept all us young teachers out of the way. I have written since I was 5 years old, and I have published for about 50 years. But as I grow older, it becomes more difficult to pump up a novel. And I do short stories now, and I write my blog, I write essays, and I paint and
That's
do
wonderful.
That.
Well, what she has here tonight is called fiber art. And I didn't quite know what to expect until I saw it, and it is unbelievable. And I hope you'll have an opportunity to come down here and see it up close and personal. But tell us about any one of these pieces you want to talk to about.
Okay.
And tell us how you do this.
Well, let me talk about one of them. Oh, let's talk about the big one there. I call it lovers. Trees can be lovers too. They are separated by a stream, and you notice their branches sort of lean towards each other. Star-crossed Romeo and Juliet type trees. I like color in my work, as you can see. And the process is simple. I put down fabric. I have some idea of what I'm going to do. I cut freehand mountains or trees or whatever I need to put down. And it all gets fused together eventually. And then it gets machined, appliqued, and then quilted. But it takes a while.
Why, it must. Well, you're not actually painting the fabric. You're picking
some of it.
Some of it is painted.
Some of it is painted.
Yeah,
some of it doesn't get that right color, or that you need the shadows, or you need something to bring out the beauty of what it's supposed to be. And usually it comes out very different from what I plant.
I think all artists feel that way. They start out with an idea, but then never comes out quite that way.
Sometimes I have been lucky in that I actually draw a rough sketch, but very seldom.
Mm-hmm. So. Yeah. The work is beautiful. And tell us about some of the books you've written. You write children's books, is that right?
I have written children's books. I have written mainstream novels. My young adults, the latest one, was called Yuri's Brush with Magic. It was published in 2011. And I've just had a ebook of my book, The Lake is on Fire, which has been out of print for many years, but I love that book so much I put it on ebook, which is a salute to the electronic age.
Ebook is a wonderful, wonderful device for writers to get their stuff out there.
I imagine so. I always feel that anything to do with computers has to do with magic. I have absolutely no idea what happens, but I use it.
Well, I think most of us of our age are kind of like that. In the old days, if it was mechanical, I could look at it and say, oh, I see how that works. And now you just have no idea how it works.
But it's
pretty special. Well, tell us, do you have any work anywhere else that we can see it? Are you displaying anywhere at this time?
At the moment, no. In April, I will have a part of a six-man show down in the Visual Art Exchange in Raleigh. That will be a good time for me to produce something more.
Wonderful.
It takes a while to get new inventory, you know.
I'm sure it does. Was there anything else you want to tell us about your work?
Well,
your methods?
Most of it is inspired by something I've seen or something I've felt or something that has happened in the past. They all have stories of some kind. The writer in me, you know.
Sure.
But I think the process is very much the same. It's just the idea. And I think if you talk to any artist, they will tell you the same thing, that you have, it has to come from some part of us, some part of our psyche.
Well, we at Clayton Visual Arts certainly appreciate you coming out and exhibiting this month. We hope to see you again real soon.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
I'm pleased now to be here with Rhonda Peters. Rhonda lives in Goldsboro now, but fairly recent to North Carolina.
Well, we moved here. My husband Steve and I moved here about 8 years ago, actually, to escape the cold weather. We like your climate much better here.
You originally lived in Illinois.
Yes, the northwest suburbs of Chicago.
And you were an optometrist.
Optometrist, yes. I practiced there for many, many years. And when we moved here, I retired. And I started to spend more time with my photography.
Yeah, I don't think you started photography at all until, the 90s or something like that?
That's true.
Yeah.
I think I bought one of the first SLR automatic does everything cameras when it came out because I thought it was cool. I dabbled in it and then got a little more serious once
your work is beautiful and
well, thank you.
It's very varied.
Yes, eclectic. I don't seem to be able to concentrate on one theme. I just like to photograph whatever appeals to me at the time. I do gravitate toward vintage items though, and setting up my own images, still lifes. Sometimes unconventional still lives, I think.
Whimsical.
Whimsical.
Whimsical
at
times,
yes.
That's
a good one. So. But I like going out and, you know, finding old barns, old trucks, other things like that, old houses to photograph. And
now
just
I see. You actually got into photography before the days of digital.
Yes, I did.
I bet you miss that, don't you? working with that film and paying for the film.
I went into digital screaming and yelling. I'm never going to go into digital. And then when the quality improved, I had to switch it.
I think that's what most photographers have said over the years. They finally give in because it's so much you can do with it and it's so easy to work with once you once you master those programs and so forth. So.
But yeah, I did a lot of slide film shooting. I shot a lot of orchids for the Orchid Society that was in Chicago. And yes.
I think you were on the cover of the Orchid magazine one year, weren't you?
You're right. I did. I did make the cover one time.
You've made the covers of several other magazines and all.
Here and there. Mm-hmm.
Something here in North Carolina.
Yes, it was a tourist promotional somewhere on the coast. I can't remember the name of it now. But yes, they chose my photograph for a monthly publication.
That's wonderful. That's exciting. Those are the things that keep you going, isn't it?
That's right.
Well, the work is wonderful, and I want to thank you for exhibiting with us. But you have supported us for quite a while now.
Yes.
You have been to our Millstock art thing.
Mm-hmm. Several years now, the art festival there. And I think this is a very nice facility that you have to exhibit work. And
well, we're proud of it.
Mm-hmm.
You were in our art fair.
Yes.
And you won an honorable mention, as I recall.
Well,
or an award of excellence.
Actually, last year I did manage to win the photography award, much to my surprise.
Was that the award of excellence? Is that what we call it? Yeah, the
yes.
Margaret Ritchie Award
yes,
of Excellence.
Yes, that was it.
Excellence. Yeah. Well, that is an honor.
Yes, it was.
Well, we're happy that you won it.
Thank you.
Is there any place where you display your work regularly that people could go see it? Or?
Well, I do have a website that you can browse that. But otherwise, I spring, summer, and fall, I I do attend some art festivals, and you can find me there occasionally. But other than that, I think my website would be the best place.
Why don't you tell them what your website is?
Well, it's rgpetersphotography.com.
R.G. Peters.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Is there anything else you would like to tell us about your work?
No, I just thank Clayton Visual Arts for allowing me to exhibit here. And I think that's wonderful. And I think that's it. Thank you.
Really pleased to have you. And I hope you'll get an opportunity to get down to the Clayton Center this month and see this work. It is, it's wonderful.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next month at the Clayton Center on December 5th, we're going to have another art opening. We have two artists. One is Maria Belluis. She's from the Cleveland area, and she works in oil paint and beautiful work. The other artist is Lynn Fry. Lynn Fry lives in Oxford, and she has been here before, and her work was very popular. So I hope you'll have an opportunity to come down and join us for some refreshments and see the art on December 5th at the Clayton Center.